Before importing an SVG file in Slingshot, you need to be sure that the format is correct. Unluckily, this is not always easy to check when working with files downloaded from the internet. The procedure we're going to show will assure you that your SVG file will be rightly imported in Slingshot. To start the procedure, download and install the free software Inkscape from its own website. Once the software is installed, double-click on the icon to open it. You should now see the main page of Inkscape with a white editor. Go in the top left corner and click on the folder icon to open an existing SVG. Select the SVG file to open it and then click Open. Here we will open an already downloaded file. Inkscape can also open the .exe files and directly convert them to SVG, as we will later show in this video. So, if your downloaded project is a .exe, we recommend you to convert it with Inkscape and follow the same procedure we will now show for SVG files. When you open your project, you will see it in the editor window. Check, by zooming out, that no parts of the project were imported elsewhere in the editor area. You can now click on the white area and drag to select all parts of the project. Now, go in the dimension toolbar and change the unit to millimeter or inches as you prefer. Here we will work with millimeters. Then, click on the lock icon to block the proportion of the project. Move to the W field next to the lock icon and select the number shown. Use the combination of keys Ctrl+C to copy the number and save it for later. We can now proceed to the top left corner and click the tab file. Here, scroll down until you reach Document Properties. Click to open the Properties window. Now, let's change the display units with the same we set earlier in the dimension toolbar. So here, it's going to be millimeters. You can change the paper to the one that best fits your project. In this case, we will leave it as it is. Then, change the custom size units to the one previously chosen, so millimeters. Change the scale to 1. You will see that your project will resize. Go back to the W field and after selecting all, paste, by pressing Ctrl+V, the number that was previously copied. Then, press Enter. You should see your project going back to its original dimensions. Reposition your project on the paper and close the Document Properties window. Keep the project selected. Now, you can go to the Object tab and select Ungroup. Move forward to the Path tab and select Break Part. You will see that your project is now colored in black. Select all the project once more and go to Object. From the drop-down menu, click on Fill and Stroke. A new window will appear. From the Fill tab, select No Filling. Then, click on Stroke Paint and select the Flat Color option. Your project should be now back to its original design. You can now save your project as an SVG. Your SVG file is now ready to be imported in Slingshot. Let's open Slingshot, open a project. We can now go to the import icon and select import in current canvas. Let's check that the canvas is at 96 dpi and then browse for the file you want to open. We will now open the file we've just made with Inkscape. Click import to import the file in the canvas. You should see your project appearing on your canvas. Click and then drag to select all the parts of the project. set the cut to outline. Now you should be able to see all of your project's path. Your project is now ready to be edited and then cut with Goliath. We will now go through the same procedure with a DXF file to show a common issue when converting DXFs to SVGs. Let's open the DXF file in Inkscape, and when the import window shows up, check that the method of scaling is on manual scale and leave the scale to 1. Let's proceed to do all the steps shown at the beginning of the video. We can now save to SVG and import it in Slingshot. To import, click on Import in Current Canvas and select the file you've just created. Once the figure is imported, you can see red dots appearing. These dots mean that the figure is not seen as a closed figure, but as a group of open segments that you can see listed in the track list. The software allows only outline center type of cut for open segments. To solve this problem, let's head back to Inkscape. Start by choosing the Edit Path by Node instrument from the left toolbar. Click and drag to select all figures on the canvas. Then, repeat the click and drag selection to select all nodes present. Click on the Join Nodes instrument in the top toolbar. All your nodes should be now highlighted by a blue diamond, meaning that all segments were joined. In this case, now, there are two closed paths. Let's proceed to save the file modified and import it in Slingshot again. You can now see in the tracklist that there are only two paths. Let's set the cut to outline to see the imported figure. You can also spot that there are no more red dots, meaning that the figure was correctly imported. Once your project has been correctly imported, you can proceed to do the panel detection.